My topic today is vacuum arcing. Have you heard about such a magnificent phenomenon? I'm sure that many of you have seen lightning in a stormy weather or sparks during a pipe welding. All of these are different forms of electric discharge, also known as arcing. When we search for arcing in the internet, we find many terrifying images of lightning near any high voltage device, such as electric transmission lines, trams, and so on. Yes, we feel uneasy to see these images because we do not know what harm lightning or arcing can cause to us. However, it is fascinating to understand how and why magic appears and try to befriend it and work together. The curiosity has its practical aspect. The eagerness of humankind to learn more about the universe around us or create safe and affordable sources of energy require development of new technologies capable of building large and powerful, far exceeding human capabilities, machines that are working with electricity. To drive the technological progress forward, it is not enough to have a knowledge and basic knowledge of electricity. It is of capital importance to understand how the interactions between atoms, the building blocks of our world, can change under electric fields and how these changes result in phenomena which can be seen with the naked eye. I imagine that many of you would not go close to a bunch of metal wires if you see sparks on their surfaces, is it not? The sparks are the indicators. High voltage is danger. Why is it so? Because intuitively, we associate sparks with high voltage, which is dangerous to a human body. Indeed, sparks are small local plasmas of electric discharge, or they are called electric discharges, which appear in places of particularly high electric fields. They light up like candles if there is something to burn. While burning, the sparks consume energy, destroy expensive components, and create many technological nuisances, limiting performance of the electric device. How can we solve the problem? Let us set the metal wires in vacuum. The higher the vacuum, the better. Since vacuum is the absence of atoms of any sort, there will be nothing to burn at all. Most likely the problem is solved. Good. To some extent, yes. The voltage now can be risen higher, but yet far below theoretical limits. Why so? Because the metal surface can still provide the source of neutrals, which can burn even in a full vacuum. Here is a name: vacuum arcing. Metal surfaces are never fully clean. They easily oxidize. The carbohydrates and many other chemical elements present in the air are easily attached on metal surfaces, which can be fuels for future plasmas or vacuum arcs. In this case, let's clean the surface, remove possible fuels for plasma. Did we now solve the problem? The modern surface cleaning techniques have reached very high standards, but some atoms and molecules are impossible to remove. Unfortunately, the vacuum, in spite of our technologies, is never perfect, and the residuals always remain, slowly depositing on clean surfaces again and again, offering more opportunities for future sparks. The problem sounds like asking for technological solutions. Try this and that, maybe you will solve the problem. However, none of the phenomenological approaches that were used so far to understand the causes of vacuum arcing proved themselves successful. But solutions are needed to drive the technologies forward. For instance, it has been already shown that a humongous multi-kilometer machine can be built with a micron precision where the high electric fields will be used to accelerate charged particles. However, if solution of how to mitigate vacuum arcing near those metal surfaces is not found, the size of this accelerator will grow even larger, increasing the already expensive construction costs. It is clear that the understanding of how processes involved in vacuum arcing is necessary, and without a rigorous theoretical understanding, no further progress in the field of high voltage application will be possible. In my group of materials for accelerator technology at Helsinki Institute of Physics, we address this issue on different levels. We also closely collaborate with the accelerator physicist in CERN. Our experiments with pulsing voltage applied between two metal electrodes, which are separated by a very few tens of micrometers, show that those residual molecules from vacuum are not key obstacles for smooth performance of metal surfaces. They still can work in the very high electric fields by just rising the voltage gradually from low values to its target values in this pulsing mode, just giving the voltage in very short pulses. And then we can easily control the frequency of sparks, and eventually we will reach the high voltage which we want. In these and other experiments, we see that vacuum residuals can burn really relatively easily, and short period of this pulsing is needed to eliminate this effect. But what is much more intriguing and really very interesting to me is that arcing behavior correlates with the material itself. So this is really something fascinating for a scientist, and we do need to understand this dependence. If we do, we can design a material which will behave exactly as we want, keeping the number of the sparks during the operation under a strict control. For this, we need a deep knowledge and good understanding of what happens to materials under a high electric field. Since electrodes are the ones to supply atoms to feed plasma, there should be a mechanism of how these atoms are detached from the surface in these circumstances. Several decades of intense research all over the world, not only Finland, have not yet led to answers. Since the theoretical and experimental tools which are needed to describe these processes, which start from the individual atoms and develop all the way to the full-size plasma of several microns, they are too diverse for a single model. This is a challenge we took up in my group at Helsinki Institute of Physics and Department of Physics. We develop a multi-scale and multi-physics model. This model includes processes on different time and length scales, atomic redistribution under high electric fields, mechanical modifications in material due to stresses caused by electric fields, appearance of surface tips emitting electron currents, and finally building up plasma out of neutrals which are evaporating from these overheated emitters. The work is not easy, this is clear. It employs a variety of computational techniques that are able to resolve different scales. We were able already to provide important insights of how to treat the surface to reduce probability of vacuum arcing, and also how the plasma is fed in ultra-high vacuum. We do not have yet all the answers. The work is still in progress. But soon, we will be able to understand the phenomenon all the way to its roots. And then we will be able to reduce the damaging effect it introduces and increase the potential applications for new developing technologies. I'm really happy about this project and I'm very proud of it, but this is only one of the examples of what we are doing and how the understanding of behavior of materials in extreme environments is important. In our group, we work also with many other scientific issues aiming to understand the hidden mechanisms inside of materials, which reveal themselves only in the condition if material operates in extreme environment. And this extreme environment can be ion or neutron irradiation, like in this fission and fusion nuclear plants, high temperature and pressure. I thank you for listening and viewing this video, and I hope that you found it interesting.